Hello all the students, welcome to the online class of Matrix Methods of Structural Analysis. Now in this third unit of stiffness matrix method for the analysis of bar and truss, we have completed the bar part, and in last video lecture we have started with the second part of this unit, that is analysis of truss using stiffness matrix method. So here we have completed the derivation of standard stiffness matrix for truss element. So that is given as K equal to AE upon L, and a matrix of order 4 by 4 containing the 16 elements in terms of L square, M square and LM. Now we'll solve the numerical example of analysis of truss using this standard stiffness matrix to find the displacement of the nodal point. So here this is the first example. A simple truss geometry is shown here, that containing the members AB, BC and CA. So here the problem statement is analyze this truss using stiffness matrix method, and cross sectional area of these three members are given here. For AB 1000 mm square, BC and CA 800 mm square, and value of Young's modulus is given 2 × 10⁵ MPa. So using this data we have to calculate the displacement of these nodal points. In figure you can see support A is given hinge support, B is given roller support, and C point, it carries a downward force of 120 kN. So let us start the solution. So in solution, the very first step is to find degree of freedom. So as we have discussed in last video lecture, that for truss element there are 2 degrees of freedom per node. So here total node numbers are 3, that is node A, B and C. So for each node there are 2 degrees of freedom, so total degree of freedom here it will be 6, that is we'll write in a bracket, those 6 degrees of freedom are nothing but the nodal displacement, 1 in x direction, 1 in y direction. So in x direction we'll use the letter u, and in y direction we'll use the letter v. So for each node there will be these 2 types of displacement. So for node A, horizontal displacement ua and vertical displacement va. Similarly node B, ub, vb, and for node C, uc and VC. So these are the 6 degrees of freedom, horizontal, vertical displacement at these 3 node points. Now the next thing is to calculate the properties, parameters of this stiffness matrix will require this calculation for L and M, and this calculation AE upon L for each element. So for that we'll prepare the table. Okay, this type of table, the same as we have done in bar analysis. So very first column it is of member, the next column, that is x2 minus x1 which is required for the calculation of this direction cosine L, which is given as L equal to x2 minus x1 divided by length of member, and direction cosine M is given as y2 minus y1 upon length of element. So for that, to calculate this L and M, we require this difference. So x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, total length of that member, direction cosines L and M, AE upon L, and last column, that is boundary condition. Now, to have these values of coordinates for nodal points, so first we need to find, we need to assign the origin here, origin for this system. So origin it is chosen in such a way that the your whole structure it is in a positive quadrant, that is in a whole quadrant. So here we'll choose this point, that is the axis passing through the lowermost axis, that is C axis, x axis it is passing through this C point, and y axis passing through this A point. Okay, so this is what your global axis, x axis, y axis, origin O is here. So this way the whole structure it is in a positive quadrant, so that all coordinates of this point it will be positive. So that will be easy for this calculation. So here to write the coordinates of those nodal points. So first here we'll write for A. So see A point as it is passing through y axis, so x coordinate it will be 0 and y coordinate is the distance from origin, that is this distance. So this distance is given 1.5. So coordinate of A will be x 0 and y 1.5. Now for B, this B point, it is here, okay. So it will have both coordinates as it is at some distance from x axis and y axis. So x coordinate it is distance parallel to x axis from origin, and y coordinate is distance parallel to y axis from, that is vertical distance of that point from origin. So here x coordinate and y coordinate, x coordinate that is this total distance is given 2 plus 2, 4, and y coordinate this vertical distance 1.5. And last remaining that is C. So for C point it is passing through x axis, so y coordinate is 0 and x coordinate is distance from origin on this y axis, that is given 2 meter. Okay, so this way you have to write the coordinates of all node points first and then complete this table. So in the table very first column that is members, so as there are 3 members, write down that members. First member AB, second BC, and then you can write AC or CA member. Here we have written, then member AB, for that x2 minus x1 and y2 minus y1, that we have to calculate. So for member AB, first x2 minus x1. So here you can see this A to B, right? We have considered A as first node and B as second node, that is A first, B second. So coordinates of A, they will be x1, y1, coordinate of B will be x2, y2. So very first, second column is what? x2 minus x1, that is x2 is this 4 and x1 is this 0. Okay, so x2 minus x1, 4 minus 0. 4. Y2, that is this y coordinate of B minus y coordinate of A. Y2 minus y1, 1.5 minus 1.5, 0. BC, B is first, C is second. So coordinates of B will be now here. Coordinates of B will be x1, y1 and coordinates of C will be x2, y2. So for BC, x2 minus x1, 2 minus 4, minus 2, y2 minus y1, 0 minus 1.5, 0 minus 1.5. And now for the last member CA, so C is x1, C is first node, so its coordinate will be x1, y1, A is second node, so it is x2, y2. Now here 2 minus 0, 2, 0 minus 1.5, minus 1.5. So this way this x2 minus x1 column is completed and y2 minus y1 column completed. Now write the length of member that is given. For AB it is given 4 meter. For BC this inclined length that you have to calculate from Pythagoras theorem. So consider this triangle. Here this side it is 2 meter and this side it is 1.5 meter. So do the Pythagoras theorem, its value will be 2.5. Similarly for CA member, same sides are there. So again the value will be 2.5 meter. It's written in meter. Now calculate L, that is direction cosine L. That can be calculated as this one, x2 minus x1 divided by L. So x2 minus x1 it is 4, divided by length, 4 divided by 4, 1, m, it is calculated as y2 minus y1 upon L. So y2 minus y1 for AB member is 0, 0 divided by 4, it is 0. Next, Again for the BC member, this L, x2 minus x1 divided by L, so minus 2 divided by 2.5, that is equal to minus 0.8, and M, that is calculated as this one, minus 1.5 divided by 2.5 is equal to minus 0.6. Now for the CA member, 2 divided by 2.5, 0.8, and for this y2 minus y1 divided by this, minus 0.6. Then calculate this AE upon L for each member. So let's calculate for AB member AE upon L factor. So area for member AB is given 1000 into E is given 2 into 10 to the power 5 divided by length of member. It should be in mm. So length of member, that is 4000. So this value, it will be equal to 50,000 Newton per mm. What we want in kilo Newton per mm. So in kilo Newton, it will be 50. So right here 50, and next two values are, that is 64 and 64. Okay. So this column is completed. Now writing the boundary condition. So boundary conditions, they are depending upon the support condition. So here in this A and B, A is given hinge support. So for hinge support, horizontal translation, vertical translation is prevented. There is no moment, translational moment. It can only rotate. So here in boundary condition, these two values, displacement at support A because of hinge support, both values are zero. So UA equal to VA equal to zero. Next, this related to B. So now B, at this point, roller support is given. So for roller support, this, it can roll in this direction, in horizontal direction. That means this moment is possible. So there will be a value of UB, right? There will be some value of UB. So UB is unknown here. Now this VB, displacement in vertical direction. So this roller support, it cannot move in vertical direction. It can only move in this roller direction, horizontal. So vertical displacement is prevented here. So next boundary condition is VB equal to zero. And support C, that is this point C, now it is loaded with this some load. Also this roller can move in this direction. So support C, it will have both moment in horizontal direction as well as in vertical direction. So here this UB is unknown, UC is unknown, and VC is unknown. Total three unknowns are there. Okay. So here these are the boundary condition. Now let's apply the second step, that is element stiffness matrices. For AB member, for BC member, and for CA member, we have to write this type of a matrix of order 4 by 4 for each element separately. Then we'll assemble all these three stiffness matrices into a global, apply the boundary condition, get the reduced matrix, and then again apply the condition of equilibrium. Okay, so this way we can proceed further. So here writing that stiffness matrix for these elements separately. So element stiffness matrix for member AB. For member AB, so we'll give the name as K suffix AB. K AB equal to AE upon L for member AB is this 50 into a matrix of order 4 by 4. I'll just give the dividing line here. Now, these rows and columns, okay, member AB associated displacements are UA, VA, UB, VB. So those displacement we have to write here for each column and row, UA, VA, यूबी वीबी वीए यूबी एंड वीबी बिकॉज दीज इलेमेंट्स दे आर नथिंग बट द एक्शन करस्पॉन्डिंग टू दीज डिस्प्लेसमेंट्स एंड ऑल्सो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू राइट दिस डिस्प्लेसमेंट फॉर अप्लाइंग फॉर इम्पोजिंग द बाउंड्री कंडीशन दैट्स वाई इट इज रिटन हियर फॉर ईच कॉलम एंड ईच रो नाउ दिस यू ए वी ए यू बी वी बी आर रिटन नाउ कैलकुलेट दिस दिस इज द स्टैंडर्ड स्टीफनेस मैट्रिक्स ओके सो सेम इलेमेंट्स इट विल बी हियर इन टर्म्स ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल वैल्यूज सो फॉर ए बी मेंबर कैलकुलेट एल स्क्वेयर एम स्क्वेयर एंड एल एम वैल्यू सो ए बी मेंबर इट्स एल इज वन एंड एम इज जीरो वट वी वॉन्ट एल स्क्वेयर सो वन इंटू वन इट इज एल स्क्वेयर इज वन एल इंटू एम द प्रोडक्ट वन इंटू जीरो सो एल एंड एम आर जीरो एल इंटू एम इज जीरो एंड एम स्क्वेयर एम इज जीरो सो अगेन इट इज एम स्क्वेयर इज जीरो ओके नाउ रिमेनिंग एलिमेंट्स यू कैन राइट फ्रॉम दिस बिकॉज इफ यू सी इफ यू ऑब्जर्व दिस matrix it is very easy to remember as this 4 by 4 if you divide this into by such a dividing line just for a few minutes like this so here these elements this 2 by 2 matrix it is same here in diagonal and also the same numbers appears here with minus sign okay the same thing it is there in diagonal side So here this positive quadrant and this positive quadrant it is same 1 0 0 0 and the same coordinates appear here with minus sign so minus 1 0 0 0 minus 1 0 0 and 0 so here we have completed the stiffness matrix for member AB now similarly write down for member BC For member BC, so KBC equal to AE upon L. For member BC, AE upon L is 64 into a matrix of order 4 by 4. First, have the dividing line. Write down the associated displacement. B C so first write down for B U B V B U C V C U B V B U C V C okay now calculate L square and M square so for B C member L is given as minus 0.8 its square will be 0.64 0.64 m is minus 0.68 and l is 0.8 so multiplication of this it is minus minus plus 0.8 into 0.6 that is equal to 0.48 and m square that is this minus 0.6 square is 0.36 0.36. Now we have this first quadrant. Write this first quadrant as it is here in this place. So 0.64, 0.48, 0.48, 0.36. And same values here with minus sign. So minus 0.64, minus 0.48, minus 0.48, minus 0.36. Minus 0.64, minus 0.48, minus 0.48, minus 0.36. So here for BC is completed. Last remaining that is for CA. Member CA. So for member CA, KCA equal to AE upon L is 64 into matrix of order 4 by 4 write down the associated displacement C and A. So first for C, U C V C, then for A, U A V A. U C V C U A and V A. So for this C A member, L is given as small l 0.8. So L square is equal to 0.64. Then L M product L into M 0.8 into minus 0.6. So minus 0.48 minus 0.48 and M square. This M square it is given as minus 0.6 square. So it is 0.36. Write down the same values here diagonally. 0.64 minus 0.48 minus 0.48 0.36. Now same values here with minus sign. So here minus 0.64. Now here it is minus. This here you have to write with minus sign, opposite sign. So here it will be plus 0.48 and here minus 0.36. Same values this side, minus 0.64 plus 0.48 plus 0.48 and here minus 0.36. Okay, so this way for member CA is completed. Now after this what you have to do? The next step number 3 is assembling the global stiffness matrix like we have assembled in very first problem of bar. Global stiffness matrix, that is here globally total degree of freedom it is 6. So global stiffness matrix it will have order of 6 by 6, so total 36 elements here it will be there. Okay, but you can skip that step. Directly you can impose the boundary condition itself here in this second step. This boundary condition UA is equal to 0, VA equal to 0 and VB equal to 0. And whatever the remaining contents, then you can write as a reduced stiffness matrix of order 3 by 3. Okay, so here we'll do that step number 3. Directly imposing the boundary conditions, impose boundary condition, that is UA, VA and VB equal to 0. So imposing this boundary condition, it means eliminate the row and column associated with these three displacement. So here eliminating this UA equal to 0, this column and this row related with this UA, deleted. Now related with this VA, eliminate that column, eliminate the row. And next is VB. So this fourth one, eliminate this one. Same thing you have to do in second member BC also. So here UB, VB, UC, VC. Only VB is present here. So eliminate this second column and second row related with this VB. And in third member UAVA, that is this one, third, fourth column, third and fourth row is eliminated. So this way you have to impose the boundary condition. As those displacements are 0, so action corresponding to those displacement for the calculation of these displacement UB, UC and VC it is not required. Now after imposing the boundary conditions, write down reduced stiffness matrix. So reduced stiffness matrix step number 4. Reduced stiffness matrix. I'll write here as capital K equal to now this matrix it will be of order 3 by 3. because we have imposed the boundary condition, these three conditions are imposed here, those are deleted. Now remaining things, whatever the left over, they are related with this UB, UB, UC, VC. Here also UC, VC is remaining. That means total three displacements are remaining. So those displacement first we'll write here, UB, UC, VC. Similarly, this side UB, UC and VC. So this matrix, it will have order of 3 by 3 as it will contain 3 rows and 3 columns. Now assemble these elements. So very first element here, the element in UB column, UB row. So find that element, such element UB, UB combination from these three matrices, do the algebraic sum and write down final value here. So UB, UB, it is here. So 1 into this 15, which is outside the matrix common factor AE upon L. So this value, it is 50 here. Then search in the second BC member. So UB column, UB row, this 0.64 into 64, that value. So 50 plus this product. And in third matrix, it's related to CA. So UB combination, it is not there. So total value here, it is equal to, that value is equal to 90.96. Now the value here in UC column, UB row. You have to search this type of combination, UC, UB, or you search like this, UB column, UC row. Because you do the calculation like 1 plus 2 or 2 plus 1, the same answer. So it's the same thing again here. That is, if you write KIJ, that will be equal to KJI. Okay. So the elements at this position and at this position, both are same. So search the combination like UC, UB and UB, UC. And then do the algebraic sum and write down here. So here, this first matrix, the value is already taken. Now you have to search only in BC and CA. So here, this UC, UB, minus 0.64 into 64. And after that, the next value, it is UC, UB, UB, UC. It is here, 64 into minus 0.64. So the same thing here, UC, UB, this 64 into 0.64, that value is equal to minus 40.96. UB column, UC row, UB column, UC row, 64 into minus 0.64. Same value appears here, minus 40.96. Okay, that value completed. Now here it is VC, UB, VC column and UB row. You have to search this combination out of these three matrices. So here AB, it is already covered. Now in BC, VC column, UB row, VC column, UB row. So this value, it is equal to 64 into minus 0.48. So that value is equal to minus 30.72, same value that will appear here. Or you can again search in these three matrices, UB column, VC row. So UB column, VC row, 64 into minus 0.48. So same thing, minus 30.72, minus 30.72, same values. Okay, now the middle one, that is of combination, the element in a UC column, UC row. So UC, UC combination. So that is here, UC column, UC row, that is 64 into 0.64. Also in a CA matrix, UC, UC combination, UC column, UC row, that is 64 into 0.68. So two times, 64 into 0.64, the value is 81.92. Now the next combination, that is next element under this VC column UC row, VC column UC row, that is here. Okay, 64 into 0.48, VC column UC row, that is positive, plus 64 into 0.48. And again here in this CA, in CA matrix, VC column UC row, VC column and UC row, that is here 0.64 into minus 0.48. So in BC the value is positive with same value 0.64 into 0.48 minus 0.64 into minus 0.48. So the value is equal to 0. If you search under VC, sorry, UC column VC row, you will have same value 0, 0. Now the last element, that is under VC column VC row. So VC VC combination, it is here 0.36 into 64 and also in this 64 into 0.36. So total value is equal to summation of the value from BC and CA, that value is equal to 46.08. So here this reduced stiffness matrix is completed, K. Okay. So instead of going for global stiffness matrix, we have directly applied boundary conditions and then we have written the reduced stiffness matrix. Okay. Now next step, number 5. Step number 5. That is to write equilibrium equation. So equilibrium equation is what? P is equal to K delta, or K delta is equal to F. Okay, the same thing. So here P is what? Nodal force vector. Okay, nodal force vector. K is this reduced stiffness matrix and delta is these unknowns, UB, UC and VC. So here first I'll write down this K matrix, 90.96 minus 40.96 minus 30.72 minus 40.96 minus 30.72 81.92 0 0 46.08. Okay, this K matrix, delta matrix, that is unknown displacement UB, UC, VC. Now we'll write this nodal load vector, nodal force vector. So here there will be three elements, right? So very first element that represents here, what you have to write? Here you have to write the force corresponding to this first unknown displacement. That is first unknown displacement, here it is UB. So action corresponding to this horizontal displacement is what? It should be horizontal force. If it is a vertical displacement, it should be vertical force. If it is horizontal displacement, it should be horizontal force. So in problem statement, in problem figure, is there any horizontal force present at B? B, at B support, if you see the problem figure, at B point, it is a roller support given. And at that point, no any other force is defined. So here, as there is no force present corresponding to this UB, so this value is equal to 0. Next is, second displacement is horizontal displacement at support C. So here, in second element in this P matrix, it should be horizontal force at C in problem statement. So in problem statement, horizontal force is not given there. So here again it is value 0. And last, that is VC. V, that is vertical translation, vertical displacement at support C. So in problem statement at support C, there is a force present, that is downward force of 120. So here that value will come here. And as it is downward, therefore right here minus 120. So this way, this P matrix, it is written which is associated with, it is the action corresponding to these displacement in problem statement in original structure. Okay, so that is completed. Now from this you can rewrite the equation, three simultaneous equation containing these three unknowns, calculate those values and find the answer. That is the last answer here. It is equal to UB equal to minus 1.6 mm value of UB, UC equal to minus 0.8 mm and VC equal to minus 3.67 mm. So these are the answers for the nodal displacement. If you want to calculate the member forces, then as we have discussed in bar element, to calculate the forces of that bar member, for that you have to do, you have to write this equation for each member separately. That is P1 is equal to K1 into delta 1. So it will be of order 4 by 4 all matrices. That is, this matrix will be 4 by 4 and this will be 4 by 1, 4 by 1. Solve that for this unknown matrix, you will get the member forces for all the members AB, BC and CA. So here we have completed this truss analysis problem using